nickel Cl4, that is tetrachloro nickel 2 complex. So let us have, in tetrachloro nickel 2 complex, the central metal atom is nickel, having 28 atomic number with valency shell electron configuration 3d8 4s2. But in nickel tetrachloro nickel complex, actually nickel identified to be present with, or the oxidation state of nickel is +2. That means the two electrons from s orbital eliminated out to produce this type of configuration 3d8 4s0 4p0. The same thing let us write here. In nickel complex, tetrachloro nickel complex, the oxidation state of nickel is +2. Hence the identified electron configuration for nickel +2 is 3d8 1 2 3 4 4s0 and 4p0. That means out of the 5 suborbitals, 1 2 3 4 5, 3d8 we have to fill 8 electrons, whereas the last 2 d orbitals with single unpaired electron, where there are no electrons present in 4s orbital and 4p orbitals. Now in the presence of 4 chloride ligands or ions, there is no rearrangement of orbitals present in 3d orbital takes place. That means remains unchanged, all the electrons present in 3d series are remains unchanged. In such case, 1 4s orbital and 3 4p orbitals participates in hybridization and can produce sp3 hybridization. So due to sp3 hybridization, how many empty orbitals are available now? 4 empty orbitals. The 4 empty orbitals are going to form or accept electrons from chloride ions. The 2 electrons from chlorine and 2 electrons from chlorine. This is also 2 electrons from chlorine, and here is also 2 electrons from chlorine. So via sp3 hybridization, 1 s orbital and 3 p orbitals, sp3 hybridization, it is going to make bond, coordination covalent bond with 4 chlorines. So just identify in the finally resulting structure, while we are going to observe the final resulting structure, the 3d series with 2 unpaired single electrons, the 2 orbitals with unpaired single electron, therefore it is a paramagnetic species. It is a paramagnetic species. Second one, due to sp3 hybridization, the structure of the molecule is tetrahedral. It shows tetrahedral geometry. So this is what structure of nickel or tetrachloro nickel 2 complex. Similarly, let us consider one more complex, tetracyano nickel 2 complex. So the same, the oxidation state of nickel in tetracyano nickel 2 complex is +2. The same explanation like the previous, 3d orbital with 8 electrons, where 4s orbital 0 and 4p orbital is also with 0 electrons. But in the presence of CN minus ligands, the 2 electrons present the two electrons or unpaired electrons present in last two d orbitals, interchanging takes place. Sorry, not interchanging, pairing of the two electrons takes place, which results as the formation of 3dh, 4s0 and 4p0. What is this? The last orbital electron jumps from this orbital to this 3d orbital and can offer vacant 3d orbital, last 3d orbital. Now, while four cyanide ligands approaching nearby cobalt, there is four vacant orbital available. So one d orbital, one s orbital, two p orbital. Hence the hybridization is dsp2 hybridization. So via dsp2 hybridization, it makes 3d8 orbital, 3d8, where one d orbital, one s orbital and two p orbital combinedly produces dsp2 hybridization, and four dsp2 hybridized orbitals are going to accept electrons from four cyanides, like this: cyanide, cyanide, cyanide and cyanide, make the formation of tetracyano-nickel 2 complex. Here, in the formed tetracyano-nickel 2 complex, all the orbitals are filled with paired electrons. So here is two electrons, two electron, two electron, two electron. Every orbital filled with paired electrons. Therefore, it shows diamagnetic character. The species or the central metal atom with metal atom or ion with paired electrons. So then the coordination compound will exhibit diamagnetic character. And due to dsp2 hybridization, it shows square planar geometry instead of tetrahedral geometry. So sp3 hybridized species shows tetrahedral geometry, and due to presence of unpaired electrons left in the d orbital, it is with paramagnetic character. Whereas the same central metal atom, but the ligand is changed. By changing the ligand, here all the electrons or the resulting hybridization is dsp2, and in the resulting compound at central metal atom, all the paired orbitals are present, hence diamagnetic character. And due to dsp2 hybridization, it shows square planar geometry. So this is about valency bond theory. Okay, valency bond theory, which shows or which explains about how the formation of four coordinate and six coordinate metal complexes takes place. So remember, the first explained concept compound is outer orbital complex, and second explained, that is hexacyano nickel 2 complex, is inner orbital complex. So outer orbital complexes and inner orbital complexes, all it takes place based on strength of the ligand. And now let us explain magnetic character. Magnetic character. Here, per the previous explanations, valency bond theory will explains the formation of coordination complexes as with the consideration of their magnetic behavior. So the same thing, the metal complexes in which the central metal ion or central metal atom with paired electrons shows diamagnetic behavior. Similarly, those metal complexes in which the central metal atom or ion with unpaired electrons or single electron shows paramagnetic character. So to identify magnetic behavior of coordination complexes, magnetic behavior of coordination complexes, the most importance goes to valency bond theory. So let us consider the metal atoms or metal ions with D1, D2, D3 type of electron configuration. That means we can consider it as titanium plus 3. Titanium plus 3. Because in titanium, what is the valence shell electron configuration for titanium is 3D2, 4S2. But in titanium plus 3, that means the titanium have to eliminate 3 electrons from valence orbit. So for this, 3D1, 4S0. So these type of ions are called as D1 configuration ion. Because of the number of electrons present in D orbitals are 1.